next location on my Florida trip is Busch Gardens, Tampa. And I've only got an hour and a half tonight and then the next two full days. As you can probably expect, I'm starting off with Iron Gwazi. Now, it's been a couple years since I last rode this RMC Hyper Hybrid, but I remember it being amazing. So, let's see if we can get on this thing before the park closes. Not off to a good start. I got to Iron Gwazi. I found out they closed it early for the night because of the fireworks. So, guess I'm not getting on that one today. Oh well. At least we still got Cheetah Hunt that should be open. So, let's go make them a first ride of the day instead of Iron Gwazi.
Come at sunset too. Come at like 5.
No Velocicoaster, but I think this thing does a great job of being just a pure fun ride. And it's probably the best coaster out there that focuses on just pure fun, so I have no complaints about it. Now let's go to Montu and get a ride on that. Hopefully this thing can redeem itself from when I last rode it in 2022. In 2022, I never got the left outside, and so my rides were kind of underwhelming, which the best seat on this ride is left outside, no matter which way you get. I was gonna try and get the left outside and see if Montu can redeem itself, so let's head over there and get a ride on it. Made a complete wrong turn. I went past Iron Gwazi, which I realized that's not what I'm supposed to do. So, let's head back this direction and hope I find it before the park closes, which it closes in about 20 minutes, so I gotta get over there fast. I just saw the top of Montu's lift hill, so we're getting pretty close. I just gotta hope they didn't close the line early. Just rode Montu, back row, left outside seat. My gosh, that was intense. That was pretty close to the intensity on the Incredible Hulk coaster, which I rode a couple days ago. My arm is sore and my legs are sore, so that's how you know you got a really good ride. And this is still, by far, the best B&M loop for this park. Was it better than Miranda Cheetah Hunt? Maybe, actually. That was amazing. That last course, I forgot how good that element is. Like, that was the part that threw me by surprise, as well as the Batwing, which that Batwing is probably the best element on the ride. Even that in the last course, now that I think about it. Zero to Roll is also great. In terms of the ride count from today, since the park's now closed, there's one on Cheetah Hunt and one on Montu. So, we got two full days ahead of us. So let's jump to the first full day. Started my first full day at Busch Gardens Tampa with a front row ride on Cheetah Hunt, first train of the day. Now I'm gonna ride Cobra's Curse because I know this thing will break down most likely because the last two times I've been here, I haven't been able to ride it more than like once or twice because the line is always closed. So I'm gonna do this now and then go ride Montu in the front row because I did back row yesterday. Then I'm gonna do Iron Gwazi. I know you're probably thinking, why don't you just do Iron Gwazi now? The problem with that is that thing runs really slow in the morning and it was disappointing. So I'm avoiding that mistake by doing some of the other rides that I know will probably get longer lines. Then, in turn, allowing Iron Gwazi to warm up.
Hey, no, yo!
Iron Gwazi, but that line was 2 hours, and I'm like, I ain't waiting for that. I would be more likely to wait for it if I wasn't doing the Roller Coaster Insider Tour at 1 o'clock. Since it's a little bit after 11 right now, I would miss that tour if I waited for Iron Gwazi. So, I'm gonna do some of the rides in the back of the park while waiting for that time to come, like Tigress, Sheikra, and unfortunately, Kumba. I am really nervous about what Kumba could possibly do to me this time, because in 2021, it gave me a bruised ear from all the headbanging despite riding defensively, and then in 2022, it gave me the worst headache I've ever had after even more defensive riding, which didn't work. Who knows how bad Kumba will be this time, but I'm gonna ride Tigress first, so let's do it. Just just rode Tigris, and I forgot how good these Premier Ride Skyrocket 2s are. I will say that the comfort cars were a bit bothersome on this particular ride compared to my other rides, but it was by no means a deal breaker. Now I gotta go ride what is my least favorite coaster in this park, which is Kumba. I already gave the reasons why I don't like this thing, and I just gotta hope that it's not running Train 3, which Train 3 I found out is a bad train not long after my trip here in 2022. So I did a poll on Instagram a while back that said, even if Kumba is running Train 3, if I do it, if it's only running one train, and a lot of you guys said yes, which you got the results on screen right now. So if they're only running Train 3 today, I'll skip it and come back tomorrow. But if they're only running Train 3 tomorrow, I'm still gonna do it. Otherwise, you guys would hate me for not riding it. So I'm gonna hope they're not running Train 3. They're not running Train 3, thankfully. They're running Trains 1 and 2. I just gotta hope none of these are running. 2021, strike 1. 2022, strike 2. 2024, strike 3. Kumba is out. Still the worst ride in Florida by far. So much headbanging, even though I was riding defensively, although I was stuck with an outside seat because there was a group of four behind me in the front row. I was in Train 2, so much headbanging, especially in the second half. Some of the worst headbanging I've ever had. Definitely a one and done, and by far the worst ride of the year.
To make sure that nobody can turn on the ride while we are on it, while we are out there. So there's a bunch of stuff here on panel.
Thank you.
favorite ride I've had operated definitely is the National Ski Trip.
Oh, yeah. Did you have to wear, like, the...
Yep, I have to wear shorts on there, but there's times I've been, like, working here.
Yeah.
No, because if you're there...
Just finished up the Roller Coaster Insider Tour, and that was amazing. Cheetah Hunt was really cool, getting to go into the maintenance area and see some of the parts used on the trains and whatnot. Columbus Crush is pretty cool, because you got to go up into the panel area, and then Monty was by far the best, because you got to go up part of the mid-course, which is amazing. That was by far the coolest part of the entire tour. I would say it's definitely worth the time if you're looking for rare photos or videos of these three coasters, especially Montu, because going up that mid-course, you can't really do that every day, so that's pretty neat. And I think that is the second time I've ever gone up part of a coaster's mid-course to get shots from it, the first being Boss at Six Flags St. Louis during Daredevil Days in 2022. And since I have not done Iron Gwazi yet, I am heading over there right now to get on that, because I was waiting to do that until after the Insider Tour, which that just concluded. So let's go ride Iron Gwazi and see how it holds up.
No, I don't want to have to carry more stuff.
Okay.
Plus, this will just blow up my nose with her. It'll blow up my...
Well, you can shorten it.
Made it back to Busch Gardens, Tampa. Now I gotta see if Iron Gwazi is still open. I know yesterday they closed early, so if they're closing early again tonight, that would suck, because I haven't been on it yet and I really want to ride it. So gotta hope for the best with this one. They are still open, so I feel extremely lucky to have made it. Last time I've ridden this, I've ridden several RMCs that people consider to be the best, including Medallia Levity 2, Air Force 1, Wildcat Revenge, Outlaw Run, and Lightning Rod. Let's see how this one holds up. So a lot of people say this is the best one still. Was amazing. The tracks were still wet since it had rained a little bit ago, and that definitely made a difference. But I will say I do still prefer Lightning Rod and Outlaw Run over this in terms of RMCs, but this thing is still amazing. Mr. Freeze at Six Flags Over Texas cracked my top 10 a little bit ago, and that knocked Iron Gwazi outside the top 10. Did Iron Gwazi break into my top 10? I still don't know. I haven't decided, but if not, then it's definitely number 11 for me.
Thank you.
got a dusk ride on Cheetah Hunt, and I think that'll be my last ride of the day. I want to try and get out of here before the fireworks finish so we can beat the traffic out, but overall, today was a pretty good day, other than the fact that weather closed the rides down for a couple hours, and also that Kuma was absolutely terrible. Ride count from today was 3 on Cheetah Hunt, 2 on Cobra's Curse and Montu, and then 1 on Iron Gwazi, Kumba, and Tigress. Got one more day here, this time with Quickie, so let's jump to it. Second full day is underway, and I probably shouldn't do this because it's gonna run really slow, but I'm starting off with Iron Gwazi. To be fair though, I only rode it once yesterday, and I do have Quickie today, and this is not Quickie. So if I want to get on it quickly without having to wait early in the morning, it's like the only time I'll get to do that. So that's why I'm doing Iron Gwazi first thing this morning, even though I know it's gonna run ridiculously slow. Got the first train of the day on the back row of Iron Gwazi. That is not running slow. Oh my gosh. I thought that was gonna be one of the slow morning rides like I got in 2022. Not an issue this time. I don't know what the deal was. That's why it's already running so fast. Whatever it was, that was amazing. Still don't know if it's in my top 10 because I do tend to prefer speed over airtime in a lot of cases, but that last ride was awesome. Just rode Cheetah Hunt, and that was fun as usual. Now to start making my way back towards Scorpion and Sheikra, because I did not ride either of those two yesterday.
Yeah!
there's a cheetah about to run. I've never seen a cheetah run in person before. Oh, there he goes. Oh my gosh. And there he goes.
Wow.
Oh, she's
amazing.
Wow, that guy's fast. Oh my gosh.
And an excellent job by Chi.
Wow, that is incredible. The last few times I've been here, the sky ride's been closed. This is my first time being here when it's actually open, so let's give it a try.
Thank you. Antes de subir a Tigris, Bush Gardens no asume...
ride Chikra, but then I heard from my brother that Montu was running trimless on the mid-course. So I come over here, ride Montu. Sadly was not trimless, but it was still a really good ride. Then I did Cobra's Curse again, which I thought it would spin. It really didn't. So that's three rides and three attempts where I didn't spin, but that's all right.
Thank you.
about Iron Gwazi in the front row, and I don't know which row I prefer out of this ride. In 2022, I said the back row was better. Then again, I do tend to prefer speed over airtime in a lot of cases, so I might be leaning towards the front row now. Plus, in 2022, I seem to overlook just how insane the sense of speed in the front row is. And on top of that, the same elements hit in the front and the back, well, besides the drop, obviously. I'm tempted to move this ahead of some speed machines in my list, those being Orion at Kings Island and Fury 325 at Carowinds, but as of now, I still don't think I can do that. Iron Gwazi still lands just outside my top 10, but who knows, it could break in after a couple more rides. Is a one and done on this trip. The ride wasn't bad, but there were a lot of wasps at the top of the lift hill and at the holding brink. So I rode as still as possible, just in case a wasp had landed somewhere on the train and therefore it wouldn't sting me. So that was terrifying, which the wasps were swarming at the top of Iron Gwazi too, so that's not good. Now I'm gonna go over and I think get some more shots of Kumba and then go ride Scorpion, because I haven't done Scorpion, man. I've been wanting to do that for a while. Anyone would want to wait 999 minutes for Tigris, but that's definitely not me. Trying to get shots of Kumba, and they were cycling empty trains for some reason, but then they said it was gonna be at least another hour before the ride got back up. So let's go ride Scorpion now.
Thank you.
I still stand by the statement that Scorpion is more intense than Shockwave at Six Flags Over Texas, which I wrote a little under a month ago. The loop is more intense than the ones on Shockwave, in my opinion. This helix at the end is insane. Overall, I would say it's a better ride. And I forgot to mention something about Chikra. After riding Dr. Diabolical's cliffhanger at Six Flags Fiesta Texas, also less than a month prior, I do think that kills Chikra for me personally. But then again, Chikra, I was kind of stressed out about the wasps possibly stinging me, so that kind of killed that ride for me, whereas I did not have the problem on Dr. Diabolical. I heard Kumba was back up, so let's head back up to Kumba, get some more shots of it, and then start making my way back towards Cheetah Hunt, Montu, and Iron Gwazi. Towards Serengeti Fly right now, not to ride it, but to get some shots of Cheetah Hunt from over there, because I heard that you can see the S-Bends, which are actually right back here from the queue line. So this is actually really, really cool. Never seen this view of Cheetah Hunt before, so let's take advantage of it and get some shots from back here before heading towards the front of the park.
just rode Iron Gwazi twice more, did the back row and then the front row. I did move Iron Gwazi ahead of Orion and Fury 365, but I did not move it ahead of Outlaw Run because, I don't know, Outlaw Run has that extra out of control factor for being a top track wind coaster, so that made the ride feel more intense in my opinion. But maybe if Outlaw Run doesn't run as good next time I ride it, I could drop it, but I don't know. With the way that thing's been running lately, I can see it staying ahead of Iron Gwazi after this year's over. Try and get a fireworks ride on Cheetah Hunt, but by the time I got back into the station and on the train, the fireworks will probably already be done by now because the line's long. So I'm gonna go try and get one on Montu instead. Plus, I've already gotten a fireworks ride on Cheetah Hunt, whereas I have not gotten one on Montu. So let's see if I can figure out where the heck Montu is, because I know it's this way somewhere. Like, I see the lights from the Litzel back there, but I don't know how to actually get there from here. Which, oh yeah, I think about it, it's this pathway here. So I don't know how I missed it the first time, but whatever. I thought they were gonna be doing fireworks tonight, but little did I know they don't do fireworks on Mondays here, at least during the summer. So that was definitely interesting. I got last ride of the night, front row on Montu. No trim before the batwing, so that element was 10 times more insane. Frequently, whenever I've ridden this thing this year, my left arm has been hurting, likely from the intensity I got on the Incredible Hulk coaster within the last week. Good last ride to end my trip to Busch Gardens, Tampa on. Count from today was 4 on Iron Gwazi, 2 on Cheetah Hunt, Montu and the Skyride, and then 1 on Cobra's Curse, Scorpion, and Shikra. As for what the total ride count over my entire time here at Busch Gardens Tampa was, I'll share that with you guys shortly. Final ride count from the entire time I spent here at Busch Gardens Tampa was 6 on Cheetah Hunt, 5 on Iron Gwazi and Montu, 3 on Cobra's Curse, 2 on the Skyride, and then 1 on every other coaster here with the exception of Air Grover. In terms of highlights, Montu was the biggest surprise, honestly. It was running so good this year compared to 2022, and even 2021, which I thought 2021 was way better than 2022. Also, Tigra has proven to be a really underrated ride, and I forgot how good Premier Ride Skyrocket 2s are. As for disappointments, the wasps at the top of Iron Gwazi and Shikra's Lift Hill were annoying, Cobra's Curse not being that good, and I gotta mention the elephant in the room, Kumba, being a total disappointment as it was still rough despite not being in Train 3. That tells me that it was a ride that was just rough rather than the train. One thing to mention about Kumba that I forgot to mention yesterday, I have now ridden all 3 B&M sit-downs in the US in the same year. I rode Wildfire at Silver Dollar City back in March, and then I did Hulk and Kumba on this trip, so that's pretty cool. Overall, it was really good to get back to this park, but I will say I feel like it might have been my least favorite of the 3 experiences I had when visiting these parks, because I had an amazing experience at both SeaWorld Orlando and Universal Orlando. But then again, Busch Gardens Tampa is still a great park. And before you click off this video, please be sure to leave a like if you haven't done so already. Be sure to comment what you enjoyed about this video, and be sure to share it with someone else, man. If you're new to this channel like we saw, please consider subscribing for more content like this. My goal is to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so I'd appreciate you subscribing and turn on the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. I also have an Instagram account for the pictures I take whenever I visit the park, so you should check me out there as well via the link in the description. While this may be the end of the Florida section of this Florida trip, we got 2 more parks left that we're going to be stopping at on the way home. The first one of those, and the park you'll be seeing the next vlog from, will be Fun Spot Atlanta, so stay tuned for that. Until then, I'll see you later.